With instances, we can turn a few meshes into complex scenes, without bloating our memory and while keeping our materials smart and procedural. Whether through the geometry node system or by means of some old-fashioned ways, let's have a look at a few options. But before diving in, just a quick overview on the file structure. Ideally, we would need a main collection where to store the final output of our work, and a different collection containing the single pieces to be instanced, organized into their own sub-collections. I placed each piece into their starting position, with the origin points right at their center and with scales and rotations applied. Select the mesh to instance, press Shift-S and move the cursor to selected. Add a plane, scale it down and make sure it is placed into the same collection of the original object. Select the mesh, Ctrl-click the plane and hit Ctrl-P to make this its parent. Now, go to the Planes Object Property tab and under Instancing select On Faces and disable it in both the viewport and the render. At this point, all you need is to place an array modifier on the plane, and with each iteration a new instance will pop out. Play with the offset and, if needed, scale the plane in object mode to finalize the positioning of the instances. In case of multiple meshes to be instanced at once, just select them all, Ctrl-click the plane and establish the parent-child relationship as usual. You can then repeat the same steps for all the objects you wish to instance. And even though we are actually just spawning a bunch of identical copies out of our original meshes, Blender is still capable of telling each single instance apart. We can prove that by creating a new material and assigning it to all of our meshes. In Cycles, you can do that easily through the Override option located in the Layer Properties panel. Add now an Object Info node and take a look at the output of its random socket. As you can see, every instance is assigned with an independent grayscale value, which will come really handy when working with materials. We will make use of that in a minute. But let's focus first on another cool possibility, which is using nested instances. As an example, I have already placed in my main collection an instance of this Corinthian capital. If we look at its original collection, we can clearly see that these acanthus rings are indeed just instances of a single mesh. The same is true for these other pieces here completing the composition. Nested instances can give you a hint of how you can build up complexity very easily at a little to no cost for the system. To distribute our column capital, we can use the very same method applied for the entablature. This time, instead of parenting the original meshes to the plane, we can simply parent the nested instance itself. The important bit here is to notice that nested instances still allow for full material randomization, as each single component has its own different grayscale value, just like it was the case for regular instances. For the body of the column, I prepared three different pieces with different details sculpted in it. The idea here is to create multiple variations by stacking them on top of each other with a random value applied to the rotation along the Z-axis. Let's duplicate the placeholders we used for the column capital, apply the array modifier, tab into edit mode and with the vertex mode active, press M and collapse. In the Geometry Nodes tab, drop an Instance On Points node, drag the first piece of the column into the editor and connect it to the instance socket. Reposition it on the Z-axis with the help of the Transform node and feed a random value into the Z socket of a combined XYZ node. We can now plug our vector into the random rotation socket, allowing the Z-axis to rotate between the chosen values. Let's then apply the same concept to the other pieces of the column body and merge the resulting geometry at the end. With everything now in place, we can work on the overall material. In the shader editor, I have already plugged in the textures of my base material. We can make use of the random grayscale information coming from the object info node in a couple of ways. The most obvious is to mix it directly with the base color using the overlay or multiply blending mode to add random variation to the albedo map. Another option is to use it to randomly offset textures. In fact, whenever we plug a texture in, we can see that it is repeating identically for all of our instances. Let's drop a texture coordinates node, take the UV output and feed it into a separate XYZ node. Recombine the coordinates and drop in between two mesh nodes set on add for both the X and the Y axis. Since we are working in the UV space, which is two-dimensional, we do not need to manipulate the Z axis. Set the values of the mesh node to 0 and connect the node 3 to the texture. You can see that we are right at the start, but as soon as we plug the random output of our object info node in, everything starts looking beautifully random. I took a bit of time to play around with material and instances, and this is my final result. And that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed the content and see you next time.